Hi, it's Colleen, and welcome to the WOW YouTube channel. I hope you'll subscribe to our channel so you never miss another one of our videos. Today, as part of the June challenge, I'm going to show you how to build rich ombre color with WOW powders and coordinating inks. Catherine Pooler has designed some embossing powders that coordinate with some of her inks. Here we have Cummerbund, Skylight, and All That Jazz. And there are embossing powders that match those inks, which is a fantastic idea. So you can see as I show you a close-up of Cummerbund, how the embossing powder matches the color of that ink. Now with Skylight, you have the color in there, but you also have some ultra high embossing powder, which really gives it some texture and interest. And the same applies with All That Jazz. You have the color in the embossing powder, but also you have ultra high embossing powder. So it's really fun. Now here's what it looks like when you do an ombre effect using those three colors. And to get the powder over the color, all you do is take your WOW ink pad and dab it over the area you want. Now I break it into sections and I dry each section in between. So what I do is I start by adding my embossing powder over the Cummerbund inked area, and then I will take the Cummerbund embossing powder and go right over the top of that inked up area and I'll dry it off. And I will repeat that process two more times with the two other colors and coordinating embossing powders. And this is what the finished effect looks like when you've done the whole thing. And it's stunning. The embossing powders are translucent, which means that color will show through. So this is the perfect type of embossing powder to use when you want to add ink first, because when you add the powder, you will still see the color of the ink show through. But the cool part with Catherine Pooler's embossing powders is that you can use them without the inks. And you can see on the right what it looks like if you go without the inks. But I really like the rich, vibrant color that you get when you add the ink first and the embossing powder over it. But basically, look at the different looks that you can achieve just by playing around with this. Now, here are three inks that create a great ombre effect, but I don't have the matching embossing powders, so here's a little trick. I'm going to go in with the translucent disco ball ink, which is also designed by Catherine Pooler, and it's a gorgeous, gorgeous ink. And I'm going to put that over the top of my inked up panel. And because it is a translucent color, you will see those three gorgeous purple colors show through. So like we did with the first one, we're going to ink up the card panel, only this time I'm going to ink up the entire card panel because I'm only using one embossing powder. I'm starting by taking my ink pad, my ink refill and conditioner, and getting that ink pad nice and juicy because I'm going to be using a lot of it on my card panel. And then I just apply a generous amount of that sticky embossing pad over the entire panel. And once I've completed that, then I'll be able to go in and add my embossing powder. Aren't those colors beautiful? I just love those three colors together. Now I use a white sheet of paper to catch the extra embossing powder so that I'm not wasting any of it. And then I'm going to add my powder, and you'll see when I'm done that I will take the excess powder and put it right back in the container so I can use it again next time. Make sure to tap off the extra embossing powder before you dry it. And now I can take all that excess that's on that paper, put it right back in the little container, and that's it for that. No waste. No want, right? Now I'm grabbing my WOW heat tool, which is amazing. It's got two settings, and I'm going to use the higher setting here to heat dry this. And I want you to see what it looks like when your embossing powder begins to dry. It starts out looking matte, like it does here. And as it dries, you start to see a glossy finish take over. Like, can you see where my finger is pointing? Can you see how that glossy area is getting bigger and bigger? That's the embossing powder drying. And that's how you know your embossing powder is dried, when it goes from matte to glossy. And I will finish drying my entire card panel. And because of this Wow Heat Tool, it dries very quickly and your card panel won't warp. So this is a great heat embossing tool to have. Now, look at how gorgeous that looks. You can see the shine and the glitter from the embossing powder, but you still see all three of those beautiful colors. Here is a card that I made using the three colors that I just showed you and the embossing powder, and I put it on the butterfly, and I layered the colors on the butterfly so the butterfly has an ombre effect. And you can see all three of the colors and how nicely they blend together to create depth and dimension to that butterfly. Now I'm going to show you another butterfly, the same butterfly I made using the other colors that I had showed you earlier. These were the colors that had the coordinating ink and embossing powders. And look at how rich and gorgeous that is. I really think that adding the ink beneath the embossing powders gives you a lot of depth and beautiful, beautiful color. And here they look completed. And now I have background panels to use for another time. Thank you for stopping by with me today. I hope you got some really good ideas on creating ombre effects mixing embossing powders with ink. To join the challenge, you can join on Instagram or Facebook using the hashtag WowEmbossingChallenge. The winner will receive a $15 gift card voucher and a feature spotlight with Wow. Good luck!